And now the third quarter about to get going. That's the like what we're seeing from Peterson.
He went off in the first two quarters, guys, as he's capable of doing. We might see some changes here in the defensive approach they use on him in the second half.
Yeah, they've got to make some sort of change. I mean, they can't let him continue to torch him like he has been.
They tried to step in and cut him off, but just not quick enough.
And we have the benefit of replay, but I think they got that one right, which is the case most times, even though fans don't think so.
Here is Williams. Feeds it to Carter. Looking to end his cold spell. They get it back. Goes back up. The shot's good from Peterson. Peterson's got the opening bucket to start the second half for the Raptors. Here's Francis. Not enough on that one as it misses. Raptors trail by 7.
You know, it appeared to be another season where the Raptors would be near the bottom of the league, but while the Terps rock bottom and embarrassing, floated around, they made some moves and were able to go on a run to climb towards the middle of the pack.
Well, we all know the trade for Rudy Gay, the major move coming last season for the Raptors. They were able to get a look at the playoff scenario at times. And, you know, Steve, it looked like they were much more competitive down the stretch.
Yeah, this is a team that has struggled the last few years, but I think that spark near the end of the regular season gives them hope. And now it's time to start that climb, get back into the playoffs, and continue to build and become an excellent NBA franchise, because they have the potential to do so.
And a cold spell for them coming 9.5, missing the first 3 shots. Touchdown.
And it's Davis finishing it off. Davis.
Well, I love that aggression. Forget about the tip. Just grab the thing and slam it home.
Well, what a way to get second chance points.
Man, don't take any risks. Just put that ball back in the hoop.
Pass to Ross. Pocket 6. Houston needs to get a shot. Francis. And that one off the back of the rim and in. 12 points for him.
And they get one to go now after missing their first 3 shots. Maybe this will kick them into gear.
Outside Williams. The feed to Carter. That's good. Carter's got 8 points.
Offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
Houston's gone 6 of 11 when they're taking the 3-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Francis, he's guarded by Williams. Step back and squared up. And the Rockets lead by 4. In Toronto, they've gone 4 of 6 from the field since the start of the third. Vince Carter on the wing. Tries again. He takes it up and lays it in. Carter's got 4 points now in the quarter.
You got to put bodies on the glass right there. They just are not getting it done on the boards.
Yeah, they've got to do a much better job of going harder than that to the glass.
Here's Cato. And it's off the back rim. No good.
That's a shot that he sometimes struggles with. But you can't fault him for taking it. And the defense backs off like that. The goal back hasn't been an easy one, but they've managed to climb all the way out of the hole and tie this game.
To say, pretty remarkable, Steve. At one point, I thought they were done.
Shaken, and he slams it one-handed.
Man, he got fancy with that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open.
Man, I like that. And some coaches might want to see just a sure hand and lay in. Say, put as much as you can on the finish and get your teammates going.
And the Raptors making a change here. Toronto trailing. Williams gets a screen from Clark. Williams attacking. Gets the bucket. Williams has got 7.
Boy, I tell you what, nice little run here they're going on.
Now the story is points in the paint, Clark. I mean, they're getting point-blank shots every time down.
Right side, Thomas. It's stolen by Davis. Here's Carter. That one wide left. The Rockets have gone 3 of 7 on field goal attempts here in the second half. To the middle, and he jams it with authority. This game's going to take a big swing. Clark, if the D continues to clear out like that and give up easy dunks.
Yeah, that's the kind of defense we expect to see in a blowout, Kevin, or even an exhibition game, not a close game like this.
And you know, frustrated Steve is on.
Well, I just, you know what, Kevin? Come on, Kevin. I just like that he didn't choose to just lay it up there. I mean, he threw it down with force.
Williams, back to Carter. Six to shoot. Kept alive. Here's Clark. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
If you battle for the offensive rebound and come up with it, you're guaranteed a high quality shot on a follow just like he got there.
Francis, he's guarded by Williams. Houston moving it around. The pass to Rice. Or the three. That drops. Rice has got six.
That shot becomes effortless for him when the D is so relaxed. They got to get more intense.
And Toronto has possession. They trail by three. Williams gets to Carter. He dishes it to Williams. It's rebounded by Houston. Rice has got his third rebound on the night. Passes it to Francis. Mobley defended by Carter. Pass to Francis. Shot on the wing. And Houston again with the bucket.
I'll tell you what, the first half may have been a little slow, but both clubs really picking up the intensity here in the second.
I'll say that's for sure. I mean, things have really ramped up here.
Toronto, they've gone 8 of 14 on their shot attempts here in the third. Some pretty nice work. Outside Williams, Carter. On the wing, Williams. Back to Carter. Lots of room. It's rebounded by Houston. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Here's Francis. And counts the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
Boy, that was impressive, Clark. He did not hesitate to take the ball right up against the bigger defender.
Boy, I like that aggressive mindset there, Steve.
Raptors trail by 8. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Looking to end the run. And the basket good. A bank shot that time. Houston's gotten off 12 shots from beyond the arc tonight, hitting 7 of them. Puts the lead pass in front of them. He is rebounded by Murray. Toronto's gone 6 of 11 when they're taking a 3-point shot tonight. Very respectable. That's good. 8 points for him.
So far, going for more of an inside game here in the second half, and I like that. A little smash-mouth basketball, taking it inside.
There's 1:17 left in the third. Pass to Williams. Shot clock at 5. Williams with the block. Number one. He's guarded by Williams. Clark dishes to Williams. So the whistle blows on the shot, and 2 free throws for the contact right there.
Obvious fouls.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Rockets.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
And then look at the points in the paint, because they're really winning that battle tonight.
The Rockets making a switch here. And he can't hit the second. Rockets leading by 3. And here is Williams. He has 5. Here's Cato. He passes it to Rice. Lets it go with the 3. Curry with the defensive effort.
That's some more rugged play from them inside.
decent edge in rebounds thus far.
And that hard work on the boards needs to continue. That could be what swings this game eventually.
Murray. And misses it off the right side of the rim. Houston's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. The pass to Rice. Hangs home the trifecta.
Rice
has got his third bucket of the night. 12 seconds left in the third. Outside Curry. Number one. And again, Toronto no luck. Up in time. He got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And offensively, a great show for the fans through the first three quarters. It's been a fun game to watch. Rockets lead by 6. And do not go away, as we'll be back in just a few moments with the start of our fourth quarter coming up next. We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. And so it's Houston with it. 6-point game. Pass to Francis. Now Willis. Foul call. Looked like the D didn't get there in time. And he'll shoot free throws. He's off on the first. He's good on the second. Here's Curry. Outside Williams. Soft touch off the glass.
That's some grit and determination in the post. Essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Exactly. I mean, this is the time to attack on the interior and generate those easy opportunities.
Francis passes to Griffin, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
Boy, a pick was set at the perfect angle on the floor, and he used it nicely.
Well, that's a play we may see from them a few more times.
Why not? I mean, when it works, you go back to it. Make them stop you.
Outside Williams. Carter left side. Defended by Rice. The 11-footer, and that's good off the glass that time. 12 points for Vince Carter. Nuggets leading by 5. Griffin a screen on Carter. High post try, gets it to go. Toronto's gone 6-12 from outside, a very nice 50% mark, shooting the three ball well. Picked by Williams. Outside Curry. 6 on the shot clock. Number one. Defended by Francis. And not sure what he was thinking there. And the powerful one-handed slam.
What a smooth finish.
Well, he's certainly the one they want on the end of those breaks. He always finishes strong.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Yes, Kevin. Dwayne Casey was just going over the plan with his team. He told them that they simply have to step up, saying if we don't make a move now, it's going to be too late. Give them everything you've got. Kevin?
Olajuwon's checked in for Toronto. Kicks it to Carter. But they recover it.
Multiple possessions have been the story of the game, and even with the big lead, this team continues to be quicker to the ball.
The dish to Curry from outside the arc. No luck, and is Houston the other way. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Francis passes to Rice.
That fourth foul might force him to scale back the aggression defensively a little bit. He does not want to pick up number 5.
And Toronto making a change here. bounces, passes to Rice. A three-pointer, no good.
And he continues to search for his rhythm. It's eluded him to this point.
Now here's Williams. Kick by Olajuwon. Williams gets the cover. And it's Carter again missing. Rockets leading by nine. Pass to Francis. Dives for it. And out of bounds as the Raptors gain possession. Toronto's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Williams gets to Carter. Tries to snap the cold streak. And that's 2 points on the way.
No defense. He didn't really need to do the double call.
Now a timeout called by Houston. A look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Griffin, a screen on Carter. He feeds it to Griffin. It's off his leg. And the ref's whistling a kickball. So it's the Rockets now. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed. Oh,
ridiculous.
What a move.
Tore it down that time.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game right now.
Clark, there is a swagger out here on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either.
That's right. Those are phenomenal dunks to watch. So much fun. They tried to step in and cut him off, but just not quick enough.
And we have to pin it through the replay, but I think they got that one right, which is the case most times, even though fans don't think so.
Houston making a switch here. Tipped away. Griffin with the steal. Makes the lead pass.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Williams dishes to Carter. And the Raptors miss again.
Well, I like the defense there. Right up in his grill, didn't give him a chance.
Feet away. The shot is good off the backboard. They got on this roll a while ago and they just haven't looked back. The Raptors have gone 3 of 8 here in the fourth quarter. Carter off a bit from Peterson. Wide open. Here's Williams. And good hook on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Williams has got 4 this quarter. Rockets leading by 11. There of why the scoreboard looks like it does. Very passive defense.
But the finish was anything but passive.
No, he hammered that down, Clark. Superb above the rim action.
Williams attacking. Dishes it to Olajuwon. It's good. Great play by Williams to set it up.
You know, with that much of a height advantage, that's exactly what you should do. Take it straight to the rim.
Back to Griffin. Pulls up. Hakeem Olajuwon grabs the rebound. Olajuwon's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Can't get it to go. And it's Houston the other way. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Deflects the pass. It's stolen by Olajuwon. Al Carter. The pass to Peterson. Outside Williams. Pocket 6. Right side Williams. Tries to keep it alive. They grab the run miss.
Tough play underneath to give them another chance.
It's going to be a goaltending call here, so does count the bucket.
He got there late, but you do have to like the aggressiveness to go after the block. But that
Thomas checked in for the Rockets. Here's Francis. Another miss by Houston. Raptors trail by nine. Here's Williams. Throws down the breakaway jam. Clark, can you believe it? A point guard has been soaring up there.
That's a major elevation there. That's a power finish for a player at any position.
Mm-hmm. Well, he is not afraid to take it inside. We know that.
No challenge from the defense there, Clark. Could have put that one through any way he wanted.
And I love the choice there, partner. Going hard to the hoop for that throwdown.
Yeah, that's invisible defense leading to a very visible finish.
Carter outside. Here's Peterson. That's in there. Carter with the assist. Carter's got four assists in the game. Houston leading by seven. Now Elijah on inside. And the officials call goaltending, so they'll avoid the basket.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
For Houston, they've gotten exactly two-thirds of their shots to find the bottom of the net here in the fourth, 8-12. Passes it to Francis. Stripped it away. Split to Ryan. Peterson the pass to Williams. Here's Carter. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Take a look here at what Carter's been doing. He's got 14 points. And he's picked up 6 points from behind the arc.
His outside stroke has looked really good today.
He drops the first one, and that shrinks the margin to just four.
Composure in big moments. He's as cool as they come, guys.
44 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Rice. That's a nice passing there by Houston. He kicks it to Thomas. It falls! Clark, no room for error.
Kevin, gotta be perfect from here on out. You're exactly right. That was not a simple rebound. He made it look easy, but he did a good job in bodying up his man.
Houston's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. And now we've got the intentional foul. And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to play. Trying to focus now on the second. So he goes off the 2-0. After shooting the ball here in the fourth quarter, 50%.
Nails it!
What a beautiful shot to put him to within three.
You can feel the crowd here at this moment.
Yeah, that shot got them out of their seats and off their knees. Guys, they just exploded when it went down.
Well, you do what you have to extend this game and try to get the ball back.
In this situation, clock management crucial.
And the first of two, no good. Heartbreaking. And the Raptors call time here. They're losing by four. 16 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
Well, they need to draw something up here. I think they'll go for a quick two. And if not, maybe break somebody free for a long three-pointer.
And they have to know they need to foul right after the shot goes in as well.
Carter kicks to Williams. Fires the three. No good from Peterson. So it's a narrow victory for the Rockets, pulling it out for the W. Well, they don't get much more exciting than that, Clark.
They sure don't. When it was gut check time, this team kept their composure, kept their emotions in check, and got it done.
That about does it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris.